Okay, so we got our non-Mendelian genetics notes. And this stuff can be kind of confusing, so we're going to take it slow and take some good notes. So, let me get my pens organized. Non-Mendelian. Non-Mendelian traits. So first, before we go into the more specifics, we are going to define the difference between Mendelian and non-Mendelian. So let's go ahead and on our notes, write out Mendelian traits and non-Mendelian traits. So, let's get to our defining. Mendelian traits always operate on complete dominance. What this means is that they are always going to be. What this means is that the alleles, the dominant, will always 100% mask the recessive allele. So it's essentially everything you learned in eighth grade, where the dominant always mask recessive allele. This is what Gregor Mendel, if I can think of what I'm thinking. This is what he studied when he was alive. He only knew of complete dominance, given why it's called a Mendelian trait. However, since he didn't discover some of the aspects, we have non-Mendelian traits. Non-Mendelian traits do not operate on complete do not operate on complete dominance. Sorry, my handwriting's bad. So, essentially what this means is sometimes the phenotypes can merge and create a third phenotype. Sometimes they're expressed at the same time. But I'll explain it more when we get into our specific cases. So, moving on. Complete dominant. Codominant, actually. Codominant. Let's define this. So, codominance is when both traits are expressed at the same time. So, let's do an example so it makes more sense. So, we got a black, we got a black fur dog. But we also have or I do not know why I wrote that. Orange fur, but trying to think of what I'm, sorry, my words are really bad today, as you can tell. So, black fur, big B, orange fur, Big O, big O. And you notice how it's different letters? You are used to seeing two of the same letters in upper and lower case. However, this is one of your identifiers of a non-Mendelian trait, how it will have two different letters for alleles. These two can merge to be big B, big O, and that has black fur with orange stripes. Here, as you can tell, the black fur is still expressed, but the orange fur is also expressed. So that shows that they are like co-workers working together in expression. So let's see how this would work out in a Punnett square. Okay, so I drew my Punnett square. So, as you can see, our parental cross is going to be big B, big B, so black fur, with big B, big O, black fur with orange stripes. So we're going to put this in our Punnett square, big B, big B, big B, big O. We're going to fill out our Punnett square. And as you can see, you get your completed Punnett square. Let's write our genotypes. Big B, big B, 50%. Big B, big O is also 50%. So, what this means is 50% of the offspring is going to black fur. I know you can't see that. My tripod is kind of not nice. But also 50% black / orange fur. I only put / because I don't want to run out of room. But we still know that it's black fur with orange stripes. Oops, that was almost bad. Okay. So now, that's all we need to know for codominance. Both traits are expressed at the same time. Now we get to learn about incomplete dominance. Trying to scoot this up. So, with our incomplete dominance, neither trait is it completely expressed. So, what this means is that you have your two phenotypes, we all know, but they can merge to create a third phenotype. So, let's work out our example. We got, whoops, wrong color. We got big R, big R is red. Big W is pink. And these will merge, as we know up here, to be RW. But, this is when you find your middle ground. So between red, I don't know if I said this or not, but big W is white. When white and red mix, you get pink. Sorry, this video is a mess. It's been a long day. So, now we can do our genetic cross. Okay, so now that we have all of our information written out, we can see our parental cross is a heterozygous pink with a heterozygous pink. So let's go ahead and put this in our Punnett square. And as you can see, we have our completed Punnett square. So our genotypes. Big R, 25%. Because only one of them out of the four is big R. Big W is 50% since two of them have it. And big W is 25% because only one has it. So what this means, 25% is going to be red. 50% will be pink. And 25% will be white. Sorry about my hands. So, a good way to think about incomplete dominance, it is similar to a medium-sized cup. You have your large cup and you have your small cup. And when you meet in the middle, both of them are somewhat expressed, but still not. And that's how you get your medium cup, or in this case, our pink color. Our final two, you don't really have to know how to do on a Punnett square. You just have to know their definitions and how to identify them. So, our first one. Is multiple alleles. Multiple alleles is when more than two alleles are expressed for one, are needed for one gene. Wrong color, but I don't care. So, just to recap, multiple alleles, just as you can kind of infer, is when more than two alleles are needed for one gene. And then, going more extreme, is a polygenic trait. Polygenic traits are controlled, is a trait controlled by two or more genes. Now let's go over our examples for both. Multiple alleles, a good one is blood type. You have so many blood types. You have A positive, A negative, A, B, B positive, B minus, B negative, O positive, O, and O negative. And then there's more, and I probably listed some inaccurate ones. But all you really have to know is that since blood type is so complex, more than two alleles are needed to express your one gene that is your blood type. However, with polygenic traits, an example would be human height. You have so many different heights, and quite honestly, every single person on the earth probably has their own unique height, even if it's only different by a millimeter or something really small like that. So, given that, and given that everybody has their own genes, that's how you can come up with the idea that everybody has different heights, because height is a polygenic trait. So, just to recap, our non-Mendelian trait, our Mendelian traits, always operate complete dominance. So your Mendelian traits are what you're used to. Think of that. Non-Mendelian do not operate on complete dominance. Non-Mendelian is everything we've learned down here. Codominance. Both traits are expressed same time. So, remember, you got your black fur and orange stripes. Both are seen at the same time. Ooh, I almost dropped that. Okay, incomplete dominance. Neither trait is completely expressed. So, remember, this is the mixture one, where you get red and white, and they mix to get pink. With your multiple alleles, you have more than two alleles for one gene. And then polygenic is a trait controlled by two or more genes. And I'm just gonna guess that a lot of people get these two mixed up, but a good way to remember is that multiple alleles, it has two or more alleles. So you can remember when there's more than two alleles, multiple alleles. A polygenic trait is a trait controlled by two or more genes, and when you already knocked out one, you can just infer that that has to be the other. So let's go ahead and do a quick practice. So first we have our definitions and then our examples. So a trait that is controlled by two or more genes. So we can remember multiple alleles is control a gene controlled by two or more alleles. So that can't be it. But we remember that it's polygenic traits because it talks about genes and one trait. So we can go ahead and write D for number one. And then for number two, when phenotypes merge to form a new phenotype, we remember this from our red and white flowers turning pink. So here we got our incomplete dominance because they merge. Neither one is completely dominant. And neither one is, for lack of better words, dominant to begin with. When there are more than two alleles for a gene. So you can remember this because two alleles for a gene, more than two alleles. So we can remember that as multiple alleles. And then both traits are expressed at the same time. That is codominant because both are dominant at the same time. So now our examples up here. Black, white are your parents. And then in the F1 generation, 100% are gray. So, since we know gray wasn't one of the original phenotypes, we know that is incomplete dominance because they merged. Blood type, as we know, is one gene, but it has more than two alleles coding for it, so that's going to be multiple alleles, which is C. And then white, red, and then are the parents. In the F1 generation, 100% are white with red polka dots. So we can see that both traits are expressed at the same time. They're co-working, co-dominant. And then human height, as we all know, it is very complex and is controlled by way more than two genes. So we know that as a polygenic trait. I thank you for watching to the end, and please don't hesitate to reach out if you have any other questions. I understand this stuff pretty well compared to most of the other topics we've studied this year. So I will be happy to help you when you need it. And I want you to do well on the test. So please ask me if you need help. I literally have nothing else to do because quarantine. Thank you and have a good day.